All right, welcome back to the channel. Things are heating up. At the same time, the weather's cooling down, finally. But here we are, got Casey back. They are gonna start laying the block for the retaining walls. And they start with the upper wall. We call this the left side because you're facing the back of the house on the left side. Technically, I guess from the front, it would be the right. But, you know, the main deal for this house is the back, not the front. So left side, upper retaining wall. This is the one when it's done in backfield, makes that steep drop off on the side of the house between the corner and the front door. Not a steep drop off, makes it nice. And a lot of it flat for probably about 40 feet and then will gradually be blended in. So they're laying the block to knock that out. And then after they get about 2/3 of the way, you're gonna see that they will start stepping it down a little bit. This will all get whatever we put on the house. Right now, the upper one should get brick, and then it will get, you'll see it'll get a cap. So we're moving some block around with the tractor. It's a little bright out there, a little sunnier. You'll see the sun's already gone behind the clouds. You can see the blue sky behind it. So anyway, so they moved down. You see on the end that little orange deal, that's I don't know what they call it. It should be a story pole. So they set that to begin with, make their marks for their height, and then there's a string line that gets moved up as they go. Keep everything nice and level. So they did this one. It was a day. So they came in, sat, set up, started this one, then the next day got it completed, and then they're going to switch up and start on the bottom one. Now the bottom wall, and we zoomed out, so the bottom wall here, it ties in, or it's the same, the top of the wall is the same elevation as the top of the pool. It's going to come across, and then it kicks off at an angle because there's a set of steps that are going to take you from that lower area where they're at right now back up to the upper area, which is the walk out of the back of the house. I'll get into that a lot more at the end of the video, so stick around to see what we plan on doing down there. The tractor, these are 12-inch blocks, and the tractor would only pick up, and I mean barely pick up. We didn't want to really push it three stacks of block. So we had to take about half of it off and split them up between the pallets. So, yeah, that was a lot of fun. So these, we'll drop rebar in them, and then we'll bring a truck in, and these all get filled solid. And then, of course, rock goes behind it. And then, film solid, waterproofing, rock, drainage, all that stuff has to happen. So it's going to change the whole contours and how the area around the house gets used and everything. So it's gonna be pretty cool. So appreciate you watching this part. Let's get into what's next. Let's see, what am I gonna do? I think I'm gonna start yapping. So the walls are coming along. This is day three, or the start of day three. So you got that happening over there. That's worked out, comes around. I'll show you the back of them too. So one of the reasons they wanted my footing so big is that once we put the drain system and the rock in here and backfill with all the dirt, this acts like a lever. I had a couple people comment, you know, it's called heel and toe. And so what happens is you got a little bit in the front and you got more in the back, and the weight of the dirt and all the backfill is on top of that. So as it pushes against that, it also has weight that's trying to keep it from, you know, doing that action. So that's the reason for more footing in the back. So it did that. And then, yeah, I mean, that's it. So, yeah, I think the amount of rebar is probably a little overkill, but we've got it. In the grand scheme of things to us, it wasn't that big an added expense. I'd rather have a stronger wall and never have to worry about it again. The footing, the thickness of the footing got a little crazy since we had to scrape that back, and I didn't. Probably should put more rock in, but there again, we end up talking about 3 yards of concrete probably overall that was off. Every dollar counts, and I'm probably gonna be crying by the end of this project. I know I would rather go ahead and have it strong and right than worry about that too much on this part. You know, these are the corner pieces that are in there that also help keep it from going that way. And then that wall is done, so we'll end up, we'll put caps on those step down areas, and that one gets brick because the house gets brick. At least that's what's currently figured for. And I'll show you how much dirt actually goes behind that. See how much dirt's on there? Look at that. So you can kind of get a better idea now what we're going for. We'll fill it up to like here. So that'll become a better, you know, yard. And all this dirt will disappear just to fill this in. Chris was out here yesterday and we looked at it. So all that dirt will be gone soon. To about the first step down will be the level, the same level as the patio of the pool. And then this will gradually roll down and be grass and meet that level. All right, well, they got to get going, make it happen. And there's another view of that one. So we don't need near as much dirt to fill all this back in. This is kind of like when we backfilled the house. This one is going to be a lot. Yeah, so all that'll be dirt refilled. See, down into the lower pool now really well. All that they lack here is the steps. That wall's done. They're building the step. There's a little, well, not super little, but there's a column that comes out. Then you walk up. Yeah, so they've done pretty good on that. Finish this up. We've got more block coming in because we went through pretty much most of it. You see, we got maybe a cube left. But some of that is the smaller block. And we got more coming next week, so they can do that side. And Chris picked up, where did we put it? Ah, let me show you. Chris went ahead and picked up our pipe that has the sock on it with the little holes and the ones that doesn't to go behind the walls. I've got to waterproof the walls. I'm just going to use the same spray stuff from Trimco and get that going. And then we'll go over that more as we do it, but that's what the pipe's for. And I've got to decide if I want to do any, go ahead and drill through for any lighting. Get stone on it. I believe it's thick enough. I could almost do surface mount conduit. So I haven't decided because I'd love to be able to just wait till later to really set that stuff where I want. But of course we want to go and get it backfilled. So more decisions to be made. I am getting a core drill. I've got a core drill for my HDPE pipe, the 2-inch. And we'll go ahead and dig a trench that goes to the lake for that. And then we'll be able to cover that up. That'll be everything that's going in there. And so that's it. Keep on keeping on this. I'm probably going to put out a video about the retaining walls first. So this is a little sneak peek at what I've been doing up here. Really happy with how this came out. We used up most all the block. So what happens here is this comes up and comes out. So it ends up being like a little pillar. So it marks, hey, this is the entrance to the steps kind of thing. This goes up two more courses around. And this is the cavity where the steps get built that take you up to about the level where that block is over there. It's pretty much where the final grade is. Yeah, so you have steps coming out, these little pillars that tied into the pool over there. We did end up opting to, it's got a little filler piece there to make it look smooth, but we did end up opting to have this as independent in case there's some sort of failure with it. It doesn't take the pool with it, but that's really not a huge concern. Don't think that's the way this thing is built that that's an issue, but turned out really great. So this creates a flat spot here. I'm planning on flying the drone. So if I do, then right now I'm showing the drone footage and what I'm talking about, but this creates, there's the lower pool. This creates this flat area. Got the deep part of the pool. We got the lake.
Yes, well, that will be final grade of where I'm standing will end up being what that grade is pretty much till you get to where all the foam is stacked over there. So that'll get cut down and blended across there. Hope everybody enjoyed the video. If you haven't subscribed yet, consider subscribing. Hit that like button, share, comment. All that helps the channel, and we do appreciate it. And yeah, the next video, I've already got most of the footage. The next video is going to be me starting on the main floor, which I've been doing while they've been doing this. I just didn't quite get to the point where I wanted to put that video out. So this one's out. And then, like I said, the next one, we have started on the next floor. And yeah, lots going on. Going to be a big push to be under roof by Christmas. I planned on being under roof by October, but that's not going to happen. Big push to be under roof before Christmas. And we got a couple different people to decide on which windows we're going with. So I got to go ahead and figure that out, because those take like 16 weeks to get in. Lots to do, but we've come a long way. I was looking at old pictures of the when we just had the hillside and just starting, you know, and it's amazing how much has changed. So appreciate everybody's support. We wouldn't be able to do it without it. And see you in the next one.